Hello everyone and welcome to CodeFlix. So imagine you can access your webcam without actually opening the webcam and also capture images from that webcam. So today we will see how to access our webcam with HTML and a little bit of JS. So you can use it in many purposes, or you can also include in your websites for seeing who checks your website, and you can also use it in many ways you want. So today we will see how to access your webcams with only a little bit of code. So let's start. So we will be coding the HTML part first, and you can see that we have used no CDNs. So we'll be using just pure JavaScript for this, and we won't be including any CDNs for this. So we'll start with a div, and I'll give it a class called VideoWrap. And then I'll open a video tag inside it, and then I'll give an ID of, let's say we give an ID of video, and then I'll give a property called play scene line and autoplay. So as we will open, it will start and automatically, so we don't need to start the webcam. It will get started automatically as we run our codes. So I'll end the div. I have also mentioned comments for better readability. So now we'll trigger the Canvas Web API. So for that, I'll open a div, and I'll give a class called controller. And then I'll give a button. So this button will be for the capture button, for taking the snaps from our webcam, which we will be capturing. So I'll give it a name called capture. So this button will take snaps from our webcam, and end the div. And then I'll open a div again, or a canvas. I'll open a canvas. I'll give an ID of canvas. So here our captured image will be lying. So I'll give a width of 640 pixels. You can give it whatever you want, and a height of 480 pixels. This also you can give whatever you want. I'll end the canvas tag. So this will be the video snapshot. So the snapshot of the video will be taken here. Now we will start with the JavaScript, and we will be using strict mode of JavaScript. And then I'll quickly declare the constant variables equals to document dot get element by ID, and then I'll give the IDs which I mentioned above. I'll end this. So what I'll do is I'll copy this whole line and then paste it 4 times. Then I'll do canvas here, I'll do snap here, and I'll do error message element for error messages if there are any. Then I'll be writing here span error message. Here I'll be writing snap. Here I'll be writing canvas. So that's it. Our variables have been declared. Now we'll be declaring some constraints. So I'll write constant, and then constraints equal to, we'll be making an object. So audio equals to semicolon true, and video will be width. So our webcam width will be, width will be let's say 1280, and the height will be, let's say, 720 pixels. So this will be the credentials of the webcam. So I'll end it with a semicolon here. So this is our constraints which we declared. So as you can see, audio I have given true. So the webcam will also access the audio. So if we will speak something, it will also record that. And the height of the video will be this. This is getting highlighted because here it will be a colon, and here it will be a comma. Also here it will be a hash. Then we'll write our sync function. So for that, we'll write async, because we'll be using asynchronous. So async, and then function. and then I'll leave you the function name init, and then inside I'll write a try catch block. So inside the try catch block, I'll be writing const stream, and then I'll be writing await, which comes with async, and then navigator dot media device, media devices dot get user media, and then we'll be mentioning the constraints which we defined earlier. So these are the constraints which we defined earlier. This will be mentioning, and then I'll be writing a function handle success, which will be defining later with a argument called stream. Now I'll define the catch block with an argument e, and then inside the catch block I'll be writing error message dot inner html. So if you are familiar with JavaScript, you know what is this. Now I open a backtick, and then I'll write navigator dot get user media dot error, and then I'll give a colon, then a dollar sign, then I'll be opening the curly brace, and then I'll write e dot to string. So I'll write the functions, and then I'll end it with another backtick. So backtick is where the tilde lies, and then I'll end it with a semicolon. This comment will lie here, so I'll put it here, and then inside the success comment I'll be writing the function which will be for the handle success, and then I'll take the stream parameter which I passed, and then I'll mention the following things: window dot stream, and then this will be equal to the stream object which will be passing, and then video dot src object, source object, which will be also stream. Then we'll end this. Then I'll load the init function. So I'll call the init function here, give it a semicolon, and then I'll draw the image which will be capturing from the webcam. So for that I'll write where context, and then I'll write equals to canvas dot get context to get the context from the canvas, and it will be in 2D, two dimensional. So I'll mention two dimensional here, and then snap dot add event listener, and then I'll write the click. So it will happen on a click function. So on click, it will be the function which will be called, and that function will be, I'll define it here, context dot draw image, and that image will be from the video, and that I'll give the dimensions 0 0 with 640 pixels which I mentioned above, and 480 pixels which will be the height which I mentioned above. So this is it, and I'll end this with a semicolon. So now we are ready to run, so I'll open it in the browser. So as you can see, it will ask for the access of your microphone and camera. So once I click allow, then I won't be able to speak anything because it will be recording my audio also. So you would be hearing two voices. Also, I have a tape in front of my webcam, so you will see black, the whole screen getting black. But if you will try yourself, you will see that you can see yourself in the webcam and in the screen. So once I click allow, so as you can see, you could access the webcam and also capture images through that using the capture button we kept below. So if you like the video, you can share and subscribe to my channel, and thank you for watching.